So good morning, all of you. So last class, I could see the feedback from the students that as there was a lot of disturbance in my voice. So I apologize for that and have recorded the video and have forwarded that video into the group. You could refer the session, yesterday's session, if you are not able to, if you have not concentrated on that. So I request you to go to that. Right. So today I will take a very short session. I'll not take for a long time as you have a internals today. I just want to complete one topic so that we would finish with the module 4 today. Okay. I request all of you to be serious on the session and hear the session properly and try to understand the session. Right. Maybe there are many consequences with respect to the network or audio or video visibility. I request to cooperate and hear the session. And as I said today, I'll not take more time on the topic. I'll just finish with the legacy system management. Today's topics, legacy system management, so that we would complete this complete module 4. So last class, many topics had been discussed. Right, we started with the software maintenance. In the software evolution, we have just discussed what is software maintenance. It is a big topic that consists of many subtopics. Right, let me go to the PPT. So here we are. So what is the maintenance? What is the maintenance effort distribution? Types of maintenance we have studied, and along with that. We have seen what is the meaning of maintenance effort distribution, the maintenance cost we have studied, the comparisons of the development and maintenance cost we have seen. Okay, we had a comparison of two systems that had been gone through both development and maintenance, right? So try to focus on this. So here we have two types of systems that have gone through the two phases of the software life cycle, where we have a development and we have a maintenance. So in the system one, as you could see, the maintenance cost was comparatively equal to the maintenance, the development cost. Whereas in the case of system two, the development cost is quite very smaller compared to the maintenance cost. That is, maintenance takes more costlier than the development. So such scenarios I had explained you previously, right? What are the various cost factors that matters for maintenance cost? So we have gone through team stability, contractual responsibility, staff skills. Even it depends upon the staff skills and the program age and the structure. Okay. So once again, those who have joined the session, I request I will go with only a very small topic called a legacy system management today, so that we would cover this session, we would cover this complete module, so that we can start with a new module in the coming sessions. Fine. So maintenance prediction. I had a definitions on maintenance prediction. What is maintenance prediction, right? So prediction, as I said, you are going to determine, you are identifying the cost here. Prediction is nothing but what the you are determining the future, what could be the future. So you are determining the what could be the cost of the maintenance, right? So change acceptance depends upon C. So maintenance cost depends on the number of changes and cost. Okay, so this was explained last class in brief, right? With respect to the various questions and the scenarios, we do predict the maintenance. What are the factors that make you to analyze the maintenance? This we have studied, even I had explained in the last class. So let me go to the software engineering process and what are the advantages of a software engineering process. So software re-engineering process. Hope all of you have joined. So what is a software re-engineering process? In the case of a software re-engineering, you could see several steps. This diagram, in fact, it is a general model of the re-engineering process, right? So I had explained these step by step. What is the meaning of a source code translation? The meaning of source code translation, that is, so using a translation tool, so we have a different tools for a translation. The program is converted, okay? The program is converted to the, from an old programming language to a modern programming, that is modern version of the same programming language, right? Changing the versions. So then we have, the next step is a reverse engineering. In the case of reverse engineering, the program is analyzed and the information is extracted. So basically this helps the document the things in the organization, its functionality and all. So program structure improvement. So next is a program structure improvement. The program structure improvement, the control of the structure program is being analyzed here in the case of program structure improvement, and it is being modified based on the flexibility to make it easier to read and understand. Then we have program modularization. So this is also an important step. What is program modularization? In the case of modularization, so the related modules or related subparts of the program are grouped together. Which are related modules that are grouped together? And whenever appropriate, so the discrepancies or the redundancy is removed among these subgroups. Okay. So then we have data engineering. Then we have data re-engineering. So the data processed by the program is changed here to reflect the changes. Okay. So finally, data re-engineering. So I'm just repeating these concepts as yesterday's class. So many people may not have followed this concept due to some audio issues, right? So this is all about a re-engineering process. So what is this diagram depicts about? It is a re-engineering approaches, okay? Because basically what happens is the cost of re-engineering usually depends on the extent of work that is being carried out. So always there is a spectrum of possible approaches. There is a spectrum of possible approaches to re-engineering. So this diagram 9.12, what is being shown on the slide, right? You could see cost increase from left to right. The cost has been increased from left to right so that the source code translation is the cheapest option. As the cost goes on increasing along the x-axis, you could see that from left to right, the source code translation is the one of the cheapest source of re-engineering. Hence, re-engineering as a part of architectural migration is the most expensive. Okay, this is about re-engineering approaches. Then I stressed on refactoring. So what is a preventive maintenance by refactoring? So let me repeat this and let me go to the legacy system management, or else we can continue the legacy system management in the coming sessions. We are not in a hurry to complete this module, as you know, we have only one module being left, that is a fifth module, which is a software pricing and project development. So I request you to understand these concepts. So once again, if you are really concentrating, so I stress a lot, you need to understand this module one completely in order to be a computer science engineer. You need to understand this module two and three to be a part of object-oriented programmers. And you need to understand module and 4-5, so really needed module 1, 4, 5 in order to understand all the concepts of software development life cycle that is being used throughout our life, right? And that could be used in anywhere else. So you might be a part of a module 4 where you could be a part of a testing team or testing architect. As such, you could be a part of managing skills such as project planning, delivery. You could be a delivery manager. You could be a quality control management manager. So, or else you could be a developer over here, right? So you could be a developer here. So you may belong to any part of this system in software engineering life cycle. Fine. So as I said, preventive maintenance by refactoring. So we will cover up this and we'll try to wind up. Okay. So what is maintenance refactoring? So in the case of maintenance refactoring, what do we do is, so usually refactoring, it is a process of making improvements to a program in order to slow down the degradation. Okay. So in fact, the basic difference between refactoring and re-engineering. So I just want to say, so refactoring modifies a program to improve its structure and it reduces the complexity. Here, when you refactor a program, you should not add functionality. We are not adding any extra functionality, but we are just concentrated on the program improvement, how well you can improve the quality of a program. So we had end the session last class. What is the bad smells in program code? So what is the bad smell in the program code means? So what are the factors that can be used to improve through the refactoring method? Okay. So that what could happen? You may duplicate the code. You may have a long methods instead of small methods. You may use several switch case statements. And you have data clumping and you have speculative generality. So this is what we have. So what is specularity generality? It occurs when developers include generality in a program if it is not required in the future. Okay. So this is all about the refactoring method. So I just want to stress, we have covered till here evolution process, program evolution dynamics, software maintenance. So we left with the last topic called legacy system management. Okay. So even I can cover this topic along with this module 5 today. Let me not continue. So as I could see, the strength is very less today. Because of internals you have. So let me stop the session for today. And those who have not given the attendance on the chat session can give as of now. And regarding tomorrow's class, I'll just convey the message in the group by evening. Because the concepts are all important. We need a complete strength or else it is not a way to complete the portions.